Hey, what's up YouTube? It's Story of Sam and welcome back to a brand new NBA 2K22 current gen video, and today I'm going to be going over how to shoot better in 2K22. If you guys are brand new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. We are on the road to 3,000 subscribers, and of course guys, make sure to drop a like on today's video. Without further ado, let's get straight into it. So everybody in NBA 2K every year wants to learn how to be one of the best shooters in the game. How can I shoot better on my sharpshooter, on my ISO build, on my lockdown defender? How can I become a more efficient three-point shooter in the game? And luckily for you, I have all the best tips and tricks to becoming a better shooter in 2K22. So first of all, probably the most important tip of the entire video, you gotta turn off your shot meter. The shot meter has been terrible since 2K20. It does not help you at all. It is literally just penalizing you for using a shot meter. If you are still using a shot meter in 2K22, I recommend just take it off. It's really not that hard to adapt to. Trust me guys, if you just take it off, it's really not that much of a change. I thought it would be when I originally took mine off, but it's really not that big video. You get used to it very, very quickly, and it's just overall a lot easier to shoot in the game. So 100% meter off, basically a non-negotiable right there. Meter off is way, way better than having a meter on. And also, I'm not going to go in depth on all the shooting badges, but I will say definitely put on sniper. Sniper is the best shooting badge in the entire game. If you are seeing a lot of people shoot whites in 2K22 current gen, that is because of the sniper badge. It is by far the best badge in the game. If you get Hall of Fame shooting badges, put sniper on Hall of Fame because it is that good of a badge, and it helps your whites go in so much more. That is definitely an amazing shooting badge. Also, Hotstone Hunter, a great badge. Blinders, a great badge. Green Machine, a great badge. All those are great. But otherwise, you guys can pick your own badges. I really just recommend putting on Hotstone Hunter and Sniper because those badges will help you out tremendously. Now, I will say this is not a jump shot video, but the jump shot that I'm using in the gameplay, the base is Jump Shot 98. Release 1 is Rudy Gay, and Release 2 is Jump Shot 146. The shot speed is 3/4, and the blending is 60% Rudy Gay, 40% Release 146. That is my favorite jump shot in 2K22 current gen. There are plenty of great jump shots though. That is the best guard jump shot in my opinion. Look up a center jump shot because I have not made a center build yet, so I don't really know what the best center build jump shots are. But if you are a point guard or shooting guard, I definitely recommend trying out my jump shot. And also, another very important tip to shooting better in 2K22 is literally just buying jump shot boosts. They're super, super easy to buy. They're super cheap. You can literally just buy them off your phone at this point in 2K22. They help you out so much. I buy them every single game when I'm playing. They cost 200 VC per jump shot boost. Buy 10 packs of jump shots. They are definitely going to help you out a lot in games. They're going to help you hit more whites, hit more greens. Just overall, they're going to make your shooting a lot better in 2K22. So definitely buy all the jump shot boosts you can. Getting your hot zones is also very, very important. I made a video last week on the best ways to get all of your hot zones in 2K22. So if you want to watch that, I'm going to leave a card in the top right of the screen right now. So click that if you want to see how to get all of your hot zones. Hot zones will help you out a ton when shooting greens, shooting whites, and also they help you with Hot Zone Hunter. So if you don't have Hot Zones, there's literally no point in putting a Hot Zone Hunter. But once you get all those Hot Zones, Hall of Fame or Gold Hot Zone Hunter, you're going to be set for shooting green lights in 2K22. And also, one thing I want to say is make sure to play to your build strengths. This is very, very important. If I'm playing on a playmaking shot creator 99 3-pointer, I'm going to play very, very differently than if I'm playing on a two-way playmaker with a 60 3-pointer. Just because almost every build can shoot in 2K22 doesn't mean I'm going to be shooting the exact same ways with each build. On my play shot, I'm going to be three hunting the entire game, coming around screen, shooting contested three pointers with blinders, dead eye, all that stuff, trying to get as many threes and mid-range shots off as possible. But if you're playing on like a two-way playmaker or a non-shooting build that can kind of shoot, don't just like force three pointers the entire game. Don't three hunt. You got to focus on driving the ball to the basket and then like doing a step back three pointer for like a wide open shot. So know what your build is good at. Don't just force threes on a build that has like a 65 3-pointer because you will not be successful doing that. Make sure to play to your build strengths. That is one of the biggest tips I can give. And also guys, make sure to give a jump shot at least like 10 or 15 games because it takes a good amount of time to get used to a jump shot. You cannot just put on a jump shot, have one bad game, then take off the jump shot. That is the easiest way to become a bad shooter in 2K22. This happens every single year. Casual players will put on a jump shot, they have one bad game, they switch their jump shot after every single game, and they never actually learn a good jump shot. So try out a jump shot, give it a true test, and then determine how good the jump shot is for you. Anyways guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video on how to shoot better in 2K22. I really hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, make sure to hit that subscribe button button down below. We are on the road to 3,000 subscribers. And of course, guys, make sure to drop a like on today's video. That would be great. And if you guys do want to watch more of my 2K22 videos, I'm going to leave an end screen right when this video finishes to two of my previous uploads that I think you guys would really, really enjoy. So have a great rest of your day, guys. It's been Story of Sam, and I'm out. Peace.